We are going to get back to the moral disruptors now. Sometimes innovation isn't so much about invention as it is about shaking up the status quo.
Right now, 8 million children around the world are living in institutions that deny them individual love and care. Maria is one of these children. Her parents are poor and have run out of food. So tomorrow, she'll be taken away from them and brought to an institution. She will be robbed of her identity and reduced to a number. And years later, she will be released as a young adult with little education, no relationship with her family, unprepared and unable to survive in the outside world. Maria's story is not unique. This will be her future, but it doesn't have to be. Lumos is working to transform this uncaring system and can actually solve the problem by changing the equation. The same resources spent on institutions can be used to support services in the community, such as financial assistance and social programs for poor families, and training for institution personnel to become teachers and foster parents. Together, we can ensure that all children like Maria will be raised in a family environment where they get the love they need and the future they deserve.
Please welcome the CEO of Lumos, Georgette Mulheir. Congratulations, Georgette. Come on in.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Now, you've called for the radical resource redistribution when it comes to protecting children who wind up in orphanages. Can you tell us a little bit more about your vision?
Around the world, people probably don't know, but there are at least 8 million children living in institutions and so-called orphanages. More than 80% of these children have living parents, and the primary reason they are there is poverty. But they're also there because people misunderstand, and there are a lot of myths. And so much money gets poured by governments and private individuals and trusts and foundations into running orphanages that we miss the real picture. It's much cheaper to keep children in their own families, and 80 years of science shows us that the outcomes for children are so much better. So really what we are doing is we work with individual children, their families, we work with communities and national governments, but also the World Bank and the UN and the European Union, US government, to shift the massive resources away from the wrong type of care. And if we all do this together by 2050, we can make sure that there will be no children in institutions anywhere in the world.
That would be amazing. Congratulations. Thank you so much.